immigration updates for tech workers in Canada. Part 1. This is the first part of the video, which will talk about the latest updates on Canadian immigration for tech workers, which includes express entry, provincial nominee programs, and work permits. Let's begin. Please support us. Press the subscribe button now and hit the bell icon to get the notification of our video updates. Did you know? You can help us bring you the best, up-to-date, and most reliable information from Immigration Refugees and Citizenship Canada by supporting us on patreon.com with just £1 a month, link mentioned below. Let's begin the video and talk about the high demand for tech talent in Canada. Canada offers multiple immigration and work permit programs for highly skilled tech workers. Tech workers with education and experience in their fields do well in many of Canada's leading broad economic immigration pathways, both at the federal and provincial or territorial levels. The government has designed many programs to attract skillful tech workers towards them. The Federal Skilled Worker Program and a host of provincial programs, such as the Alberta Opportunity Stream, are two examples of programs designed to retain tech workers. Following are some more examples of these programs. Global Talent Stream, CUSMA Professionals, Intracompany Transfer, British Columbia, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, Ontario and Quebec. The programs that are managed under Express Entry shows the importance of tech workers. These programs have no explicit preference for technology workers, although certain provincial streams aligned with these programs do have such preferences. In the most recent Express Entry report, individuals who received the invitation to apply under the program were all technology occupations, since it is the most common occupation. Now let's talk about the Global Talent Stream. In summer 2017, Immigration Refugees and Citizenship Canada launched the Canadian Global Skills Strategy. An important element of this program is the Global Talent Stream, which is part of Canada's Temporary Foreign Worker Program. The objective behind GTS is to allow individuals for two-week work permit processing for temporary high-skilled workers. GTS has two categories. Category A is for companies that grow quickly and show the need to hire unique specialized talent from foreign countries. A designated referral partner, which is generally a governmental, must refer employers in this category to the Global Talent Stream or quasi-governmental organization devoted in developing business in given areas. Category B is for employers who hire foreign national workers for occupations listed on the Global Talent Occupations List that are in demand and have less domestic workers. This may change in future, but currently it is offering jobs that fall within 12 national occupation classification codes that are all technology-related occupations. For both the categories, employers have to pay the worker salary comparable to the average salary in Canada for that position. Category, directly or indirectly, must create employment opportunities for Canadian citizens and permanent residents. Category B must increase their investments in skills and training for Canadian citizens and permanent residents. Individuals present in Canada for work must be provided with the option to either extend temporary status or apply for permanent residence. There are several permanent immigration programs which are important for Canadian work experience, and some even require it. So temporary option to come to Canada for work can open ways of changing it to a permanent move. Who are Canada-United States-Mexico Agreement professionals? Citizens of Mexico and the United States may be eligible for a work permit under the Canada-United States-Mexico Agreement if they have job offers. This is an expedited program for Canadian employers who hire foreign workers as they do not need a labour market impact assessment. 63 occupations qualify under the Canada-United States-Mexico Agreement Professional Work Permit. Computer systems analysts, computer engineers, graphic designers, and technical publications writers are some of the eligible occupation in the tech field. This is the end of the first part of the video. Stay tuned so you don't miss the all-important second part of the video. Please don't forget to comment below and share your thoughts with us. Thanks for watching.